All right, the storm has passed. And anyhow, you can't even tell that there was a storm here. The ground is dry now and the sky is blue. But anyhow, it was only like an hour or so ago that we were getting a good sized rainstorm. And anyhow, I'm gonna get started on this again. If you watched the other video, I did these two sides. Now I'm gonna do these other two faces and sharpen that point some more. So thanks for tuning in.
Thank you.
Okay. So, just to illustrate how hot this is, I just touched it. I don't know if you saw that. And I burnt my skin. And I didn't touch it, like, super hard. I was just seeing if that edge was there. It's hot, to say the least. But, anyhow, I gotta flip it now. Got my trusty channel locks. Tricky here. And before I started filming, I tried a few things to try and squeeze that in there so that it would stop moving up and down. Like that, you know. The more pressure I put on it, it's going to move. But anyhow, I just gotta be gentle, I guess. But it's getting to a point now. Slowly. And the cool thing about this wheel is it's got ridges on this. And so as I'm cutting, it engraves those ridges into the metal. And then as I swipe across it, it grinds them off. So it works faster because of that. So.
Yeah.
getting closer to a point. Don't know if you can see that. So, a little bit more filed down, but still not quite there. I am only going to put a point on three of the nails, and the reason for that is, so three nails will go in the cross. Sorry, I don't know if I've ever explained what I'm doing, but I'm making a cross. Three nails will go in the cross, and three nails will be set at the foot of the cross. So, the three nails that will go at the foot of the cross will have a point on them. They'll look completely authentic. These ones that will go into the cross, all this end is going to be buried in the wood. And all you're going to see is the head of the nail. And so, it doesn't really matter what this looks like. Not initially, at least. What I'm going to do, is I'm going to drill a hole where I'm going to plant this and just lightly tap it in. Like, I want it to look authentic, and I want the head of the nail to look roughed up, but I don't want to bang it up, if that makes any sense. Anyhow, so this one is mostly done now. All I've got to do is take it to my friend. He's going to weld on that head, which is going to come out another probably quarter of an inch. And I'm going to have to knock down that weld, and we'll probably stick this in the fire. Well, the authentic looking ones will stick in the fire, heat them up a little bit, and then bang them up a little bit on the body of it, you know? And just to kind of give it that look that it's blacksmithed. So, anyhow, that's kind of it for this one. But, like I said, I've got seven more to do, you know. So, yeah. Thanks for looking. God bless.